everybody. Gerard Miner here with Booze Trimental, the Rebooze. This is number 14. I'm here with my good buddy,
Michael Streeter.
And today is Memorial Day 2024.
Thank you for all those who served.
Yes, absolutely. Yeah. Yep.
Your father.
My father, World War II.
My grandfather was World War I.
Really?
Yep. Sandy's father was Korea. And my father was like the lucky one where he got drafted, but he was like late 50s. Got out like just a 60, and they offered him to stay longer if he wanted to be a chopper pilot, and he still figures if he did that, he would end up in Vietnam.
He probably would
have. So
good for him.
And right to the mill for 40 years.
Good for him. So. Memorial Day 2024. Today we are trying something different drink-wise, and I think this is going to be a little heavy, to be honest with you. It is a Moscow Mule, which is made up of vodka. They say get a good quality vodka. This is Kettle One vodka. This is my go-to vodka.
What's your second go-to? Mine's Tito's.
I don't like Tito's.
Stop it. I didn't mean to interrupt you.
But no, that's right.
Because I said we better find some cheap vodka just to cut down on our budget. But there's not really much of a price difference.
Well, what is the one? Sabato or something like that. It's
Shvedka.
That's $20 a
bottle. Yeah, but is that a 1.75 or?
That's a big one.
Yeah,
I just saw that at
Big Y today. That's a hangover one.
Is it?
Yeah, that's why. If I brought that in the house, someone would probably like get sick. Just looking at it, not opening it. But, oh God, brings back memories.
And so the Moscow Mule is a vodka. It has fresh squeezed lime juice. Mm. You throw ice on top of that, then you pour ginger beer. Now, this ginger beer here is from Australia.
See, if I knew you were having a Moscow Mule, we could have bought the... I got the mugs at the house.
I have the mugs. They said you it's typically served in a copper mug, but I don't have a copper mug.
And why copper mug?
I don't know.
Is it because of the taste? Give me the glass. I don't care.
Well, the guy that I watched today says you can put it in any glass, but it's typically... It's like a tradition, I guess. I don't know what the reason is. Maybe I should have looked that up, but I didn't have time.
Yeah, you know what? We're not here to get too smarty-farty. You know?
Let's try it. I don't know. A little strong.
I mean strong. Maybe I'm the one that's the alky. What do you mean strong?
Yeah, mix it up a bit.
I'm not going to use your figures.
So,
Not bad. That's a refreshing drink.
Yeah, it is. It's. I would say that's a kind of a summer drink, and it's Memorial Day, so I figured why not. I was going to do Tom Collins. But do you remember the Tom Collins that came in a package?
I remember the Tom Collins that came in a bottle.
Yeah.
The mix.
Oh, no. There's a dry powder. We used to have them at Circle Deli.
Oof, yeah.
And then you mix it with water or something, and then pour some. But I decided to go with a Moscow Mule. Give it a try.
I remember my only night ever where I thought I was do a job change was going to be a bartender. I did one night at the Hillsdale House.
Did you?
Thank God Chris Prusser was bartending because he like helped me through. But I had one guy. This was back when the Friday night. Yeah. The place was like packed. 3-4 deep.
Yeah.
Grab a Tom Collins. I go, what's that?
What the hell's a Tom?
After about the fifth one, I kept giving to him free. I don't care. At that point, I knew this ain't for me.
Right. Oh, really?
Yeah. I said, no. I could do a small, slow, casual one, but not like boom, boom, boom.
Yeah. I used to be a bartender at the Four Brothers when they had happy hours, 4 to 6, 2 hours, 2-for-1 back then. I don't think that's legal anymore.
No, but do you remember? You ever go to Polock's out in Film out?
No.
Oh my God. This was like years ago. I'm talking, we just got out of high school or maybe a couple years after. 30 cent drafts.
Oh.
Yeah. So you realize, after about your ninth one, you got a free one. If you think about it, because you got to laugh at yourself. If you make other people laugh by you being the butt of the joke, it's the greatest thing. That's what I like doing.
You know. I don't care.
No.
I really enjoy, getting together and laughing, like we do every Friday night. We were out Friday night at the house.
And you don't know whatever's going to happen, and we won't even talk about it.
No, we're not going to talk about it.
But the whole gang.
It was great.
We have the summer gang rolling in.
We got the Murphs up from Florida, and so usually about 6 to 8 of us hanging out, drinking.
And we have a couple new ones we bring in once in a while, So. It's nice. It's a good thing to do and all that.
Yeah, it's fun. Well, we're going to be missing you a lot because now it's camping season.
Yeah, but not as much.
Well, thank you. When are you going again? We're going up to Turning Stone?
In June, whatever. And I think we're going to book an extra day just because I think we're getting Juneteenth off.
Okay.
So we could book that Wednesday. So we'll be there Wednesday and leave Monday.
Okay.
So we'll see. Once a month, that's it.
Is that all you're doing? It seems like you do more.
Nah, well, towards the end, we try to squeeze in. We still haven't decided on Newport. That's the thing. I was like, what the hell are we doing?
It's expensive. I'm just letting you know.
I know. But I want to have good oysters.
Yeah, in October, we go to Newport, my wife and my daughter, Phoebe, and her husband. Maybe Tess might come. It's a seafood fest at Bowmen's Warf. And you, all you do is eat oysters, and they make freaking awesome lobster rolls. $25 a lobster roll.
But it's worth it.
Oh, it's phenomenal.
That's it.
Phenomenal.
That's like, we found that when we were down in Rhode Island, and we camped there, we found this little oyster bar, not far, I can't remember the name of it, but my God, it was like, some people say, oh, maybe it's not that good, but it's good.
Yeah.
I like it. Yep. But we had this discussion last night, no one's going to have the best oysters like the Old Mill had.
The Old Mill has the best oysters. I don't know what they do, how they do it.
Who would be your second?
You know what? I've had them at the Copacabana Lake a long time ago, and they were good.
How about Woodlands?
I haven't had them at Woodlands. But there is a place, Savona's restaurant down in Rhinebeck. They have one in Hudson.
Okay.
Savona on Thursday nights, $1.
Now, doesn't that place in Hudson, the farmer's daughter? What's that down there? The farmer's... down towards the end?
Farmer's son?
Farmer's son.
They used to have that.
Oh, because like Cindy Glenn Skidmore would go all the time and tell us about it.
They used to have the $1 oysters, and the Deckers and I would go, and we would just eat oysters. I could.
You know, unless you...
Now, how do you like to put... What do you put on your oysters?
I could put the vignette. Did I say it right?
I don't know if it's vignette or meniere's or menar. It's...
Let's call the whole thing off.
Yeah.
But I was calling it vignette or vignette.
Yeah, it's a vinegar with shallots in it or something.
And when Brett had it...
Brett? Yeah.
You could smell it. You could smell that. It was nice. They also give you the cocktail sauce.
Yeah, see, Brett's a cocktail sauce guy. Justin, my son-in-law, and I are the vignette.
I like them both.
Yeah? Okay.
But I grew up with everything with it. Any kind of seafood is always cocktail sauce.
Please. Yes. Yeah,
now, is there any seafood you don't like?
I personally do not like cooked oysters at all. They gross me out.
Not even like fried?
No.
Okay.
Nope. I've had them before and it's something about them. I don't like them.
It's interesting. They could be a little gritty sometimes.
Yeah, possibly. But I've had them and I'm like, no, okay. It's not mine. That's not me. Clams love them. I mean, we had on Friday night. Was it Friday night? Yeah, it was Friday night. Cause
where'd you go?
Saturday night. We got 10 lobsters at Big Y. $9.99 a pound.
Is that good? Okay, I'm not.
Yeah, yeah. I mean, when you consider you go into a restaurant, you get a lobster, it's probably $30-$40 per lobster.
I know why you got the lobsters.
Why?
We're going to have lobster!
My husband hit it big gambling. We're making lobster.
Donna DeMarco.
Donna DeMarco.
Oh,
you can't believe it. I got to watch that episode again. Was there doing?
He was making his clam sauce.
Which was good.
He pulled it off.
With both hands. we're going to hell. Fast. All right, so let's...
Music-wise, what are you talking about?
Oh, I was going to say, I wanted to thank Scott Kraft.
Oh, Scott Kraft for the hat.
For this hat, because the he works for the Housatonic Railroad.
He's worked for them forever.
I know. And he actually... over 20, it's like your big train's going through. Coming from Selkirk, which is like the largest... It's the geeky stuff, people. The largest yard, I think, in the Northeast right now.
Wow, that's exciting.
Wow. Right. Speaking of that...
Stand back.
We never talked about it.
What?
And I sent you the links. We never talked about this band. It's like, we're now like four episodes, or it's five in. Gutalax. Oh my God. I can't take it.
Are those the guys in a mask?
Yeah, and they're singing, and you can't, it sounds like a pig snorting.
Oh, yeah, yeah, yeah. And you like that?
No, I don't.
There are people that like it.
I know.
I guess
it's
like, kind of popular.
Over there, I don't think about it. Maybe here. No. And they might be over here like a sort of southern rock.
Like,
say,
Kid Rock or
no.
Alabama. Not Alabama. You're Leonard Skinner.
Where'd Kid Rock come from?
I don't know. He's kind of...
Skinner, Molly Hatchet, Marshall Tucker, The Outlaws.
I never got into The Outlaws.
Blackfoot.
That's the name of the band I was trying to...
Train.
Back, a Blackfoot. I see the white lights of Memphis and the Commodore Hotel. Be my Dixie Chicken.
No, that's not Blackfoot.
It's not?
Dixie Chicken. That's a little...
Little feet.
You were close.
What was?
And I listened to. We don't have room for an audience yet.
No, not yet. Steely Dan.
Yes.
Love Steely.
Love him.
Yeah.
What's your favorite song? And don't say.
Why?
Oh my! You're gonna say one of the hits. I'm gonna have one of the details.
I know. I'm gonna say my favorite song. One of my favorite. Maybe not their favorite.
They got a bunch.
They do have good stuff. I like My Old School.
I like that one. How about Kid Charlemagne?
Alexa. Play Kid Charlemagne by Steely Dan.
Here's Kid Charlemagne.
He yells
by
at
Steely
her.
Dan. Sorry. On Amazon Music.
Oh, yeah. Yeah.
How about Dr. Wu?
I've heard of it. I'm sure I've heard it.
How about Asia? AJA.
Yeah, the song.
That says.
Alexa, stop. You know who sings, you know that song, Peg?
Yeah.
We'll come back. That's Michael McDonald.
Yeah, he's
done a lot of background vocals for a lot of groups.
Yeah, they got a lot of great songs.
And they're kind of local, or they met each other locally at Bard College down in Annandale.
That's right. Annandale. That's in the song.
Yeah. Right. Taking the Wolverine.
Reading from the Annandale. Yeah. The Wolverine to New York Central Railroad.
Is that what that is?
Yes.
Why is it?
Wolverine,
what is that?
That's the name of the train. They had the Wolverine. They had guys.
Was that like Amtrak?
Before Amtrak.
Or maybe like a Metro North type thing.
Yeah, but it was New York Central.
So that's going to do it for us. And as you said, where can they see us?
On Facebook, Instagram, TikTok, and of course, YouTube. But you're watching this now.
Until next time.
I don't have an ending, but...
Yeah, we have to work on that.
Thank you very much. How's that one?